Okay, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at creating hand controllers. So go ahead and go to your front view. I'm going to go to create, NURBS primitive, circle. Actually, let's do this a little bit cooler. Let's go to Bezier curve tool. And you get all these great options where it's the there's a selection mode and it lets you create the kind of type of curve you want to make. I'm going to go with this guy where it's like a broken tangent. Now we're going to create the hand controller here. So what I'm going to do is just simply draw out a hand. You can use a circle or just create sort of this cartoony hand. And what I'm doing is I'm just sort of clicking and dragging this out. And I'll do like a three finger cartoony hand. Nothing amazing here. And a little bit of a palm. Another palm here. And I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to go to Surfaces, Edit Curves, Open Close Curves, and let it close out. So I'm going to right click here and go to Control Vertices, and I'm just going to sort of move this around and shape it so it looks a little bit better than it does. And again, I'm not terribly concerned with the quality of this curved hand. I do want it a bit smaller. Because really this is just going to hold all of my controls for the hand. But you can spend a little bit of time here and make a really cool one if you want. I mean, you should have pride in your model, right? Alright, so let's... something like this. I like that. I kind of like the way that it looks. It's really cool. It's cartoony. I've got a cartoony character going here. Actually, I want to smooth that one out a little bit. There we go. Alright, let's go ahead and shrink this down. I'm going to hit R. I'm going to go to Modify and Center the Pivot on that. Scale that down a little bit. And I'm just going to position it above his wrist controller, because that's where I'm... actually, I guess we could just put it right here. Because we're going to parent that to this. Let's go ahead and hit Control D. I'm going to move it over here. I'm going to hold R and just flip it. Actually, I kind of like the way it looks that way a little bit better. Let's flip this guy. Alright. And since this isn't going to be what moves our hand, we're actually going to use this wrist controller to move it around and the rest of these. The positioning just above the hand is good. Alright, let's freeze transform on each one of these guys. Okay. Now, just like last time, this is really just a visual placeholder here. We're really going to reduplicate it once we add all the attributes. So I'm only going to add two attributes for now, and that's a fist close, and that fist close will also be the fist open, and a finger spread. You're welcome to go in and add many more attributes, but for now we're really using it too to also test the skinning of the hand. So let's just go to Modify, Add Attribute. And I'm going to go ahead and name it fist underscore close. And I'm going to make a minimum 0, maximum 10, and I'm going to hit add. So there it is. I'm going to open up my set-driven key. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to load this as the driver. Now, what you're going to have to do is you're almost going to have to load driven for each finger and animate each one individually. So what we want to do is use our fist close, and on 0 we want all of these to be, we want this entire hand to be keyed out. So on 0 his hand should be completely natural like this. Okay, so let's go ahead and hit turn on our join so we could see through it. Now we want to select all of the bones in the hand. Now it looks like they're all selected here, but they're really not. Just the palm bone is selected here. So you want to type select dash high and hit enter, and since all of these guys are parented to the palm, all of them are currently selected. So I'm going to go ahead and do load driven for all of those. You can see all of these guys are here on the side, and if you shift select all of them here, let's go ahead and make sure we get them all. So now we have all of them selected. I'm just going to key the rotation and through the translations here. So on 0 of my fist close, all of these are keyed in this natural position. So I'm going to go ahead and hit key for that. Okay, so now all of that is keyed here. The reason is it's going to take a little bit of tweaking of each one of these bones to to get it to sort of close. That's going to take a little bit of movement, a little bit of rotation, all of that. So I'm going to select this guy now, and I'm going to do 10 for fist close. Now what you're essentially going to do, and again, this is really going to be, this is really going to show you how well you skinned your hand. So you might have to go back in, and we might do that this video, and tweak the skinning for each one of these. So I'm really just going to go ahead and make a closed fist. So I'm going to hit F to focus, so that allows me to rotate around this bone. See how that kind of is crunching in on itself? So we're going to have to go back in and fix all of that later. I'm rotating this. Let's do the same thing for this guy. Rotating this down. This one isn't as bad. And again, we really should add more geo to this so that we get a little bit nicer of a bend. And I'm going to bend this going this way. A bit like this. Again, I'm looking to make a closed fist. And notice how that's pulling the skin that way. That's not what we want. And we will have another video where we just sort of refine the skinning so that it doesn't pull. And I'll show you how to do all of that later. Okay, let's pull this in. So in this video, we're going to take a look at skinning our character. Alright, now I can key that again. Now let's go ahead and try that out. You can see we have a hand closing and opening. And that makes it a little bit easier than animating all of the bones individually. So let's go ahead and add another attribute while we have all of this stuff open. And I'm going to name this hand spread. We could call it finger spread. And what it's going to do is it's going to crunch our fingers. Finger underscore spread. We're going to do negative 10. That's our fingers completely scrunched together, and a positive 10. Alright, I'm going to add that, close this up. Now notice how it didn't appear. I want to reload the driver and select finger spread. Now I really want to make sure that all of these are still selected. So on finger spread selected, on 0 I want it to be in this natural position, so I'm going to go ahead and key that. On minus 10 I want to make sure that all of these fingers are tightly compacted. So I'm just going to kind of pull all of these fingers together. And once you get this technique down really well, I'm going to pull this down in a little bit. Again, it's really just kind of a natural like this. I'm going to go ahead and key that. Let's take a look at how it works. Our fingers at negative 10. Let's take it up to positive 10. And we're going to really exaggerate the spreading of these fingers. Now, there's times when you're animating and you need the fingers to overlap that you might need this. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and hit key again. And let's take a look at how that looks. And if we want it in its other position, we'll do 10. Now we want to create one more called relaxed fingers. So let's go ahead and add another attribute called relaxed underscore fingers. We're going to do 0, which is our position here, and then 10, which is completely relaxed. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit add. Okay. And I'm going to close this out, reload the driver, select relaxed fingers, key that on 0. On 10, I'm going to pose the hand in a very relaxed way. So something like this. Just really relaxed fingers. bring the fingers in a little bit. You know, the hand looks really relaxed there, and again it's on 10, so let's go ahead and key that, and the fingers can go from straight to relaxed, the fingers can spread, and we can make a fist. Okay, so let's go ahead and zero this out. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and now parent that to the wrist. So now when I rotate this, it follows along. I'm going to save this out. What I'm going to do as well at this point is if I go to my outliner, unparent it. Actually, I think it'll, when I copy it, it'll unparent it. I'm going to go ahead and delete this, and outside of the video, I'm going to duplicate it, bring it over to this side. Let's make sure it's in the same vicinity. Let's hit R and rotate that. I'm going to go ahead and program, or I'm going to go ahead and script all of this onto this hand. So we're going to go ahead and drive all of the keys of the hand outside of this video. Looks about the same size. In the next video, we're going to take a look at refining our model through the use of a walk cycle.